And next Monday, here on BBC2, the series takes us to California in search of some alternatives to the prevailing urban lifestyle that many of us enjoy, know about, and perhaps suffer from. That's The Long Search next Monday at 9:55. In 10 minutes, the Open Door presentation is a pessimistic vision of the future as seen by a group of unemployed young West Indians living in Bradford. Now, with the time at 16 minutes to 11, the late news on 2 with Peter Woods.
And that's all from us this week. Next Sunday, we have an exclusive interview with one of the richest and most inaccessible men in the world, Nelson Bunker Hunt, the Texan multimillionaire. He'll be answering allegations that he tried to corner the world market in silver and so brought about the great silver crash. Until then, I hope you have a good week. From Brown and me, good night.
On BBC One shortly, there's the Oneid in Line. Programmes tonight here on 2 continue in a moment with The World About Us. Then, at 8:05, the shock of the new.
The flea market was like the unconscious mind of capitalism. It contained the repressed surplus. This is where the sewing machine met the umbrella on the operating table and in due course gave birth to a whole flock of progeny, a new art form, the surrealist object.
At 9:10, Masters of the Keyboard, Lazar Bierman, performs in the Beethoven Halle in Bonn. At 9:55, international snooker, highlights of the day's play between England and Ireland in the State Express World Challenge Cup. At 10:40, the great Northfield, Minnesota raid.
Had a vision about robbing the biggest bank west of the Mississippi.
A place called Northfield.
And more snooker highlights at 12:10, round off tonight's programmes on BBC2.
Next Saturday's cinema is a nautical romp starring Kenneth Moore and Lloyd Nolan. We join the Navy next Saturday at 3:30. BBC Two. Now, Horizon, a second showing of yesterday evening's programme, which looks at the way one of the major commercial arteries of Europe, the River Rhine, has defended itself against man's progress.
The Rhine. For 2,000 years, it's been a central feature of European culture.
25.
Next Monday on BBC Two, Won't Change Places, a television special starring Marty West.
I won't change places with anyone right now. I've got a lot of place spending. The cards I'm holding are all aces somehow. It's no wonder.
Marty Webb, Andrew Lloyd Webber, Won't Change Places, next Monday at 9.
And now on to a profile of Edward Teller, father of the hydrogen bomb, in Horizon.
At 6.50 tomorrow on BBC2, the Tuesday Western is The Tin Star.
Thanks for fetching him home.
Didn't know any place a man could put up, would you?
Well, you'd have to share a bedroom with my son.
I don't mind if he don't.
I don't mind. Come on.
You made a mistake pulling that gun on a man like me. There was no reason in the world to do it. I don't like having no one lay a gun on me. No, sir. Hadn't ought to have done it, Ben. Why, there ain't a man in town lay a finger on me if I was...
Following the Tuesday Western, at 8.20, Russell Harty comes live from the Phoenix Theatre in London. And at 9 o'clock, Pot Black 81. At 9.25, Ireland, television history, reaches part 11. And Jake Thackeray and songs are at 10.15. Newsnight at 10.45... rounds off Tuesday evening's viewing on BBC2. And now on to the final programme with Evans on newspapers. And here is Harold Evans.
Before the last of my programmes on newspapers tonight, here's a stop press item from The Times. Mr. Rupert Murdoch, the prospective owner, has made good progress with the print unions on a disputes procedure. So very necessary in view of the millions of copies lost through disputes last year. But progress is slower on Manning and the other measures so very important for the newspaper's survival. Mr. Rupert Murdoch is negotiating against a Thompson deadline of noon this Thursday. High noon, you might say. And Thompson has said it will not publish the Sunday Times after March the 8th and the Times after March the 14th. So tonight, I'm keeping my fingers crossed.
It's 10.30 and time for service information for the television trade. And first transmitter information concerning Bromsgrove, Sandy Heath and Belmont.
In 10 minutes on BBC Two, Ireland plays Wales in the Indoor World Bowls Championship. Now on to your chance to hear it and see it on The Grapevine.
Yesterday's people, reading yesterday's news.
Well, the time now, almost exactly 25 minutes past one. Insomniacs might care to note that Radio 2 is on the air throughout the night, but for the rest of us, this is Peter Bolgar on behalf of all of us on 2, wishing you a very good night. Good night.
Well, the time now is 6 minutes to one. We thank you for joining us and look forward to the pleasure of your company again tomorrow night. Now, on behalf of all of us here on BBC Two, this is Roger Maud wishing you a very good night. Good night.